Shalom, beloved. A word. The Most High keeps bringing the threshing floor into my mind, the threshing floor. For a couple days now, every time I read scripture and I think of other things, the threshing floor continually comes back. I wanted to speak a word for the one third, but I'm going to bring it together with the threshing floor, because this word is for Yashavel. This word is for certain people, the threshing floor, beloved. You see, there's a blessing and a curse on the threshing floor. For the chaff and for the rubbish that is removed, that curse is pure destruction. But for the grain that's gathered in, for the set apart, that threshing floor is a blessing. In previous times, I've spoken about the threshing floor. Many of us experience different things when we're on the threshing floor. The threshing floor is in the Old and the New Testament. The grain is gathered at the threshing floor. And the beasts and the animals crush and walk and stomp across that grain to break it and separate the good grain from the husk, the covering over it, and remove the husk, the chaff, as they call it. If that doesn't remove the husk and the chaff, then the winnowing may take a big pitchfork and throw it up in the air, and the chaff is carried away in the wind. In many cases, it's gathered and burned, beloved. It's rubbish. It's destroyed. Many of us are on that threshing floor. The sin that clings to us is being crushed and removed, because the one who's gathering it in, who's called us, is the Most High. He uses his word, Yeshua HaMashiach, it brings us in. And through repentance and being humble, we allow ourselves to be broken down. We don't cling to the things of the world. Those sins, those things that weigh us down, are winnowed away. They're removed. They're trampled. Many situations that seem to hurt us, to try to crush us, all things work together for the good of those that love the Most High. He uses it to remove the chaff. But Yasharel is gathered into the barn for the work of the Lord, that grain. But when we look in the book of Micah, he also brings in the other nation to the threshing floor. Okay, this world will make us look away from what's going on right around us. It tries to send so many distractions, but the Lord is giving Yasharel wisdom, knowledge, understanding, and discernment, depth of thought. When you come to him in faith and in truth, there is a blessing that he leaves behind. He keeps putting the threshing floor on my mind. And I'm reading from the book of Micah, beloved. Chapter 4, verse 11. Now also many nations are gathered against thee, against Yasharel, that say, let her be defiled. If you watch what's going on, they know who Yasharel is. Let her be defiled. Let our eye look upon Zion. They want to destroy Yahshua through lies, through bringing in other nations and mating with Yahshua, making us eat and consume unclean things. Unclean things are not just physical food. Many of the things the world tries to feed us are poison. They go against the Most High. Again, I'm going to start verse 11. I'm in the book of Micah, chapter 4, starting at the 11th verse to the 13th. Now also many nations are gathered against thee that say, let her be defiled, and let our eye look upon Zion. But they know not the thoughts of the Lord, neither understand they his counsel. For he shall gather them as sheaves to the floor. Sheaves, beloved, to the floor, the threshing floor. Now he's talking to Yasharel. See, there's coming a point, beloved, where Yasharel rises up. Arise and thresh, O daughter of Zion, for I will make thine horn iron. You become those great animals crushing those sheep. And I will make thy hooves brass. You're crushing. Thine enemy shall be under thy feet, making you the head and not the tail, above and not beneath, the curse being removed, beloved, and put on thine enemies. Arise and thresh, O daughter of Zion, for I will make thine horn iron, and I will make thy hooves brass, and thou shalt beat in pieces many people. And I will consecrate their gain unto the Lord. There is coming a day, beloved. Just like we went out of the first Egypt, we're coming out of the second Egypt with great gain. There will not be empty-handedness. Those reparations are coming. Yes, they are. And I will consecrate their gain unto the Lord. Yes, yes, yes. We will know from whom our blessings come, and bless and give glory and honor unto the Most High. They will be consecrated unto the Lord, and their substance unto the Lord of the whole earth. Yes, beloved, we know who Yahuah is. Now we're going into the fifth chapter of the book of Micah. Those nations are going to the threshing floor. They're at the threshing floor, beloved. When he brings us to the threshing floor, he's removing those useless things. He's removing those sins that so easily beset us and weigh us down when he's got his fork winnowing it in our hands. We go to the threshing floor spiritually to remove those things that are useless. He brings us to that threshing floor. But when he brings those nations, he's going to crush them. And he's going to use Yasharel to do it. Now, we're in the fifth chapter of Micah, starting at the 7th verse. And the remnant of Jacob shall be in the midst of many people, as a dew from the Lord, as the showers upon the grass that tarrieth not for man, nor waiteth for the sons of men. And the remnant of Jacob shall be among the Gentiles in the midst of many people, as a lion among the beasts of the forest. They do not understand who Yahuah is, nor who his people are when the blessing is upon them. Yes, yes, yes. Listen. And the remnant of Jacob, yes, shall be among the Gentiles in the midst of many people, as a lion among the beasts of the forest, as a young lion among the flocks of sheep, who, if he go through, both treadeth down the threshing floor, and teareth in pieces, and none can deliver. The Lord is telling you something, beloved. Yes, yes. Thine hand shall be lifted up upon thine adversaries. This Lord talking. And all, not some, not most, all thine enemies shall be cut off. Yes, yes. And it shall come to pass in that day, saith the Lord, that I will cut off thy horses out of the midst of thee. You see, they may have many vehicles that they use against the people of the Most High. They will become inoperable. Horses, whatever means of transport, whatever means of mobility, that I will cut off thy horses out of the midst of thee, and I will destroy thy chariots, thy engines of war. This is the Lord talking. It's not a man. That's the Lord. And I will cut off the cities of thy land and throw down all thy strongholds. So it doesn't matter what different people do when they try to go up against Yasharel. The Lord is doing this. I will cut off witchcraft out of thy hand. You see, in this land, these lands which we've been scattered to, they have taught Yasharel things that are totally opposing the laws, commands, statutes of the Most High. We don't consult mediums. We don't practice witchcraft, read tarot cards, and consult the dead. No, soothsayers and the like. Amen. I will cut off witchcrafts out of thy hand, and thou shalt have no more soothsayers. Thy graven images also will I cut off. We've already begun to see that, where they're tearing down statues and graven images. And thy standing images out of the midst of thee, and thou shalt no more worship the work of thy hands. You see, many of these engines of corruption, they worship them because they give them power over other people, particularly the people of the Lord. They go against the Most High. And I will pluck up thy groves out of the midst of thee, so will I destroy thy cities. Finally, and I will execute vengeance in anger and fury upon the heathen, such as they have not heard. I have a question, because we're on the threshing floor. He's going to make the whole earth the threshing floor. Wait a minute. We're going to look at 15. Think of the threshing floor. All right. And I will execute vengeance and anger and fury upon the heathen, such as they have not heard. Are we seeing that now? All right. Let's look at that last verse, threshing floor. He's made the whole earth a threshing floor. We look at verse 13. We're back in Micah 4. We're at the 13th verse. Arise and thresh, O daughter of Zion, for I will make thine horn iron, and I will make thy hooves brass. And thou shalt beat in pieces many people. So we understand that the Most High is going to use Yasharel at some point, according to his word. And I will consecrate their gain unto the Lord, and their substance unto the Lord of the whole earth. You see, they don't know the thoughts of the Lord, neither understand they his counsel. For he shall gather them as sheaves into the floor. Beloved, the Most High keeps putting that threshing floor. Every 2 days, maybe three, just threshing floor. Wait a minute. He's turning the earth into a threshing floor. Yes, 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 beloved. Now, who is Yahshareth? Who is Yahshareth? Yahshareth, I will make your horn iron and your hooves brass. And thou shalt beat in pieces many people. Yes. And everything they stole, it will be consecrated. Their gain will be consecrated unto the Lord. Now, in the midst of this, you have a third of the Most High's people that are going to be saved. And in the midst of this, we are supporting one another. How? When we talk about love, beloved, you see, he's gathering us at the threshing floor. He gathers his wheat into his barn. They're at the threshing floor, beloved. Many of us are having threshing floor experiences. Yes, 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 we are. You see, you're humbled when you're at the threshing floor. And the shepherd is bringing us in. The farmer is bringing us in. Who's that? The word of the Most High. Under the spirit of Yahuah. He's bringing us in. We're at the threshing floor. But understand, he's changing our position now at the threshing floor. He's changing it spiritually. He's removing sin and dross and those things that are of no use to us. But now that he's bringing the other nations, he's transforming Yasharel's position on the threshing floor. Yes, yes, he is. Yes, he is. Now, Yasharel has become those great beasts that he uses to crush the grain. But you see, this grain that he brings on the threshing floor, this isn't wheat. This is the heathen that he's bringing into the threshing floor. Okay. He's bringing in the heathens to the threshing floor, the whores. Okay, and he's got his fork in his hand. He's gathering them up. How do we know? Now, also, many nations are gathered against thee that say, let her be defiled. Teach them evil. Celebrate what they do that goes against the Most High. You see, there's reached a point, beloved, where the dishonor, the stench is before the Most High. The cries of the righteous and their prayers have pierced the clouds. And they're ringing all throughout the heavenly realm. And the Most High is heard. That's why he keeps the threshing floor. Threshing floor. He's bringing those nations down. Yes, he is. He's brought the nations to the threshing floor. Yeah. All those nations that are gathered against you, wanting you to be defiled, that they may look upon Zion. But they don't know the thoughts of the Lord, nor do they understand his counsel. He shall gather them as sheep into the floor. Woo! Yes, he will. Keep threshing. Arise, there's coming a moment, Yahshua, when the spirit of the Lord is going to come down upon you. Arise and thresh, O daughter of Zion, for I will make thine horn iron. Ain't nothing going to break it. And I will make thy hooves brass. There ain't going to be no escape in that crushing blood. And thou shalt beat in pieces many people, is the word of the Lord. And I will consecrate their gain when they stole his silver and his gold and went into his temple. That gain, when he stole his people, sold them. I will consecrate their gain unto the Lord and their substance unto the Lord of the whole earth. Yes, beloved. You see, there are two different situations going on at that threshing floor. There's a blessing for one group and a curse for the other. Yes. He's going to destroy a lot of the evil that's been going on. All right. He talks about where Yasharel is. They're in the midst of many people. Yes. The remnant is among the Gentiles in the midst of many people as a lion among the beasts of the field of the forest. Oh, yes, beloved. He kept putting the threshing floor on my mind. He kept putting the threshing floor on my mind. Remember, it's twofold. With Yasharel, he removes the chase, the sin that so easily besets us and gathers us to himself. But for the world, beloved, let me show it one more time. For the world, beloved. We're going with Micah chapter 5, we're at the 15th verse. This is what the Most High says: I will execute vengeance and anger and fury upon the heathen, such as they have not heard, beloved. All right. The threshing floor. Many of you that are going through different experiences and you don't understand why different people who are doing things to you, and you don't understand the strange things you're going through. Everything, those who love the Lord, all things work together for the good. Meaning even that which seems so wrong, he turned it around, he's turning it around. You on that threshing floor because some bad experiences make us focus. It brings in that pinpoint accuracy on the spiritual level and draws us closer unto our Creator. It makes us follow his word, beloved, the threshing floor. But he's reversing the situation now. Horns of iron, hooves of brass, a lion amongst the beasts of the forest. That's who Yasharel is. And Yahuah is executing judgment. The world has become the threshing floor. And Yahuah's judgment has only just begun. A word, beloved, we're on the threshing floor. For some of us, it's a blessing. For others, it's a destructive curse, a word from the Most High. He has brought them down to the threshing floor. And Yasharel is going to trample them underfoot. Be encouraged, beloved. You are following the Most High and doing those things that he tells us to do to the best of your ability. If and when you sin or you make a mistake, you repent with intent to do it no more. You follow his word and let it lighten you. Do not follow evil nor the ways of sinners or heathens, because he's created a threshing floor and he's bringing them down. Before we go home. He's put us among many nations. This is before we go home. That is the word of the Most High. Be encouraged, beloved. Shalom.